Hello, ma'am, and welcome to 10th edition of World Education Summit. Ma'am, I just request you to kindly give us a brief introduction of yours and your school.
Vaishali Parikh, Principal Anand Niketan School, Bhadaj Campus, Ahmedabad. And since last 12 years, I have been in education sector. The most compassionate thing for me is children around me. Mm-hmm. That is most compassionate thing. And World Education Summit, last year I came to know through one of my friend, and I attended last year, and I was keen interested to attend this summit again. And since morning, lots of discussions, and since we are from same fraternity, mm-hmm. and getting new perspectives about the technology, getting into the classroom, discussion about various collaborations. So it gives a new thought process about upcoming generations, how we can inculcate all these factors into the classroom, into the school environment.
As we are talking about ICT in education system, what initiative you have been taking in your school, if we talk about in length and breadth?
Regarding ICT, definitely it's like matter of we should or we should not, but we should obviously, mm-hmm. because without that it will not. As since we are a generation ahead and upcoming generation, 21st century skills children, where they will be, so we are getting ready for them. So in our school we do have a tablet room. Tablets are used by since from grade 1 child to up to grade 6 standard students, and from 6th 7th standard onwards obviously we do have a laptops, mobile laptops, even we do have a computer labs. So from grade 1 to grade 4 we do have a precise curriculum for tablets, where children are using the tablets in terms of academics as well as their logical skills development, thinking skills development. So it's really helping us out, because earlier we were not very much clear about how to bring the ICT in the classroom. No doubt the children are very technology savvy, but the correct path was important to show us. When we got a precise curriculum along with the academics, that means the curriculum inculcated in that tablet, children are really enjoying it. They are keen interested, because textbooks obviously they will get fascinated for some time, but then when they are getting tools in their hands, they are more in, their interest is more in that area. So their learning outcome is far better in ICT, using ICT actually.
Ma'am, also wanted to know what initiative you have been taking now in terms of future perspective. If we talk about what more need to be done in terms of schooling, you
regarding ICT and or media technology using for a students, for a classrooms. The earlier the fear factor was there. When I was talking to a children of teenage, 12 year, 13 year or 14 year, we find out they are more techno savvy, and most importantly they do have a knowledge of up to what extent we should use it. They know the boundaries, and the major and most important thing is having trust in children. Because from the teacher side, from a school management side, we get into that mode, whether we should give that media or mobile or tablet and internet facility up to certain extent, and how to supervise that, and they will go beyond their limits, or they will get addicted to the technology. But it's not that. If you will trust the children, their ethics are there. When I was talking to them, they came up with the cyber bullying and all these things. They were having more knowledge than me actually, and they were sharing how to constrain that and what are the things and how we will approach when somebody is doing cyber bullying. So I guess we should not get into fear, okay, and most importantly we should have a trust on them. If I have a trust, I will tell my student, yes, you can use it, but there are certain limitations to it, and without any boundaries or regulations you can use it. what happens? That fear factor, we give more rules and regulations to them. And when we say no, they will definitely do it.
Yeah.
And when we will say yes, definitely they will say, okay, what happened? They will, parent is saying no and my school is giving me that space. Mm-hmm. So they will start thinking in a positive direction. Yeah. That is
ma'am, what are the future plans for your school?
Our future plans for our schools, school is bringing more and more technology in the school in terms of classrooms, and most importantly, bringing a teacher's training program. As I said, my students are more techno-savvy, and obviously with the coping with them and having more knowledge by our teachers, I'm looking forward for more teacher's training programs in terms of ICT.
Ma'am, last but not the least, I wanted to ask you, being the part of this 10th edition of World Education Summit, what is your take on this? What are the takeaways? What you find it good about this conference that you have been attending it again?
See, as I said earlier also, when I come for this summit, I gain a lot of perspective. I really get into more wisdom in terms of having a same education fraternity, because when we are in our own zone, we are not able to make up what is happening outside the world. And this World Education Summit gives us a whole perspective. Might be in Gujarat, what are the difficulties or challenges are there in terms of education sector. The other state or other schools are having different challenges, and when we are having discussions about it in terms of classroom methodology, in terms of collaboration, in terms of any assessment policy, so a lot of takeaways there. Knowledge is more, and we get confidence again, we are not alone. There are whole fraternity with us. So it's really interesting. And mainly, I would like to thank you, World Education Summit, to conduct this kind of summit, because there is no platform for us in the education industry where all principals or directors are get in touch with each other. We are so busy with our own academic schedule, with the teachers and students. Such kind of events, they bring us together. And thanks for that.
Thank you, ma'am. Thank you so much.